and it's probably, you know, because we are in a discussion panel, the issue of benchmarking, for me, we must start tailoring our own solutions in Africa for Africans. So there's a lot of work that has been done, but how many agencies similar to TR are there in Africa? If you were to look at maybe the programs you are running, for example, the technology station programs, how many are there in Africa? So are you going to benchmark with Germany, or are you going to benchmark amongst your peers? If you had to benchmark with other countries, China, the population size is huge. So I think we need to look home and start to develop our own matrices. I'm not in favor of benchmarking.
There's some interesting insights I'll bring to your focus there just now, but after this other one. Is important what you need to say, Tom?
I entirely agree with him. I think we have a great opportunity finally as Africa after the many years to now look within, create that African safari, I call it, because they have your Silicon Valleys, they have these places, but we have our ecosystem, which has many learnings, many experts, but we never allow them to meet at a common ground. Yeah. So that's what SAIC is also trying to do, really bring that notion of, let's look within, let's then, when we are now ready to engage with the world, as opposed to benchmarking, but to trade, but tell them our uniqueness, because there's something that is really unique about us, particularly us here in Southern Africa, we're really cousins, all of us, right? Habona matata, hakuna matata, same thing, right? So we need to build on that culture that exists in us and then sell it to the world.
And just a reminder to the Germans that we're not saying don't come. keep and the Finns, we still want you to come. Megan, quickly, just